Hey, what's up, dear YouTubers? This is SP Jackie back again. Today with another Clash Royale video, and today I'm gonna show you an awesome deck that's using Royal Giant. This is a 5.0 heavy deck. You need Royal Giant for this deck, and for this deck you need Arena 7. So right now you can check my deck over here. It contains Royal Giant, Golem, Barbarians, Archers, Fireball, Skeleton, Giant Skeleton, I mean, you know that the owls. You can replace the Royal Giant with the Giant. So that would be okay, but Royal Giant is one of the great unit as Royal Giant can attack from a distance. So let's watch some replays and we'll come to know how the deck works pretty fine. So let's do it. Here we are facing White Dwarf from Clan Extreme Slayer. So right now I'm bringing the 5.0 deck. Now you have to know how to use this deck. It's pretty awesome because it's an heavy elixir deck. You should know which elixir, which troops to release at which time. So he's going with the Royal Giant first, and I'm also going with the Golem first because Golem can distract the Royal Giant and push him back. Now also one of the great advantage of the Golem is that it may burst into the two pieces, and placing a Royal Giant Skeleton in front of Golem would help the Golem to pass by all these melee units, as a Giant Ball Skeleton will be bursting up and taking every unit out of the arena. Right now, my Golem push was actually a waste because it didn't reach to tower even. But yes, it's okay. We are building our elixir per elixir again and again. So right now, he's placing with a P.E.K.K.A. I'm placing the Archer and the Royal Giant. He was not aware of that. And after the update of Royal Giant, it is one of the great counter troop as well as attacking troop right now. You guys can see he's placing the Giant Skeleton, wrong move over here. But yes, the Giant Skeleton is going to be easily taken out by the Archers. Now, Archers is one of the great counter troop, as I say in my every video if I use Archers. Because Archers can do a great amount of damage to the Giant Skeletons, Dragons, Musketeers, and even Wizards. Now here you can see we have done a lot of damage to his right tower, and he's trying to do counter attack with the Wizards as well as the Minion Horde Army. But I have the Fireball. It is one of the great ideas if you try to do it. Just Fireball it, then you can use the arrows. It depends upon the situation, but that the guy has a Minion Horde or no. If he has the Minion Horde, you can actually place the Giant Skeleton in the front so that they will take the Giant Skeleton, they might distract it with the Giant Skeleton, and you can place some troops behind the Giant Skeleton to take that Minion Horde out. Right now we got his first tower, and it seems like he just give up because he's not attacking, he just placed that elixir pump and gave away. So right now we are going to push back for 3 crown because this is our chance. If any player left away, just do it 3 crown. So this is one of the great strategy which make attackers and defenders panic in Clash Royale. So right now our Golem is moving, we're gonna place our Giant Skeleton from the back. Let's build up an army over here, let's build the Barbarian from the front and the flying unit from the back. I'm placing for the waiting for the Minion Horde to come, and there we are. Our Minion Horde also came over here. So this is a perfect army moving towards his base. Now it seems to be much power overpowered deck. And let's place the last thing, that's the Royal Giant. That was only remaining in his deck, that's why here we are. 3 crowns. So let's move on to the another replay, and you will come to know how the active attack actually works again attacker very well. If the attacker is not using the troops well, then this strategy works very well. So we are facing Die Hard Daddy from No BS Canarians Clan. His prime profits is 2013 and mine is 1981. So we are doing the same, bringing the Golem first, and he's trying to build an elixir pump to get that elixir advantage. Now this is a very heavy elixir deck, but yes, if you're using it very properly, it might be one of the great deck for pushing to Arena 7. You can use the Royal Giant or as well as the Giant, as I said previously. So right now I'm pushing with the Golem and the Archers, because Archers are so dangerous that if they are not Fireball or Arrow, they can do a devastating damage. Now this Giant Skeleton will help the Golem to move ahead without any restriction, but the Die Hard Daddy making a cheeky move here, bringing that cannons in the front. The cannons is one of the great units to distract Bekkas, Golems, Hog Rider, or anything. Right now, this Golem just did a few amount of damage to that tower, but yes, placing that Fireball early was my wrong decision, as the Wizard would have been gone there with the bursting of the Giant Skeleton. So right now it's level 6 Giant is moving towards me and he's doing an excessive amount of damage to my tower. He Fireball my Barbarians, and there's one Barbarian left and he's doing an excessive amount of damage to my tower. This Giant is going to take this tower very much sincere health, in a very sincere health. Right now I'm at 6 elixir and he's in 2 elixir. He's placing that another elixir pump. Sorry for the misfortune, Mr. Inception, sorry. And now again I'm placing the Royal Giant in the front. Royal Giant is so dangerous that it can be easily doing great amount of damage. Now he does a very cheeky thing here, placing the Wizard into the front and then zapping the Royal Giant so as to target. Now one of the great things, you should know how to use the zap If you zap on any kind of tool, for example, you zapping mortar, matter was concentrated on your tower, then you zap your mortar, it will be get concentrated to your any buildings over to the battlefield. Right now, this wizard is going to go down. Quasi and is placing another witches and trying to push with the giant witch strategy. But this time, we have the giant skeleton ready for us, and he's going to do excessive amount of damage. But giant skeleton get pushed back by the giant. This is one of great disadvantage of giant skeleton. But yes, we have those barbarians ready, and he's trying to fireball the barbarians, and he did it again. But this time, we have this minion horde, and this minion horde can do excessive amount of damage to the giant, and he's done a very great amount of damage, almost taking our tower. But we have a great push going on over here with the minion horde as well as a giant skeleton. But this giant skeleton is going to burst out and maybe taking all units, placing the elixir pump into the wrong area as the giant skeleton one busted into bomb. And this giant skeleton, sorry, royal giant is going to do an excessive damage. There comes another golem. Might be thinking what I'm facing right now. And placing the golem is something that makes a panic, and there comes another giant skeleton. He's almost panic over here, placing the archers from the back as archers can do a great amount of damage. Right now this cannon is out, and this cannon is going to move on to this tower. He used this fireball on me instead of my use on to my tower, then it would have been another 60-second battle. But yes, this attack makes player panic. So let's move on to another replay, and you will get come to know how the deck works pretty well. So right now we are again facing Flavio 7 from Argentos. Might be a player of Argentina, so doesn't matter. We are going to do the same thing, but this time we have the giant skeleton and the royal giant combo. This is one of the combos I used in my previous videos, so you can watch my previous videos. You can actually watch my 6 golem video, which is a world record by me. So this is awesome. If you say watching my videos, that would be okay. If you are a new viewer, please subscribe to this channel for more Clash Royale and Clash of Clans videos. And I'm gonna bring more quality videos like Clash Royale for Clash of Clans. So right now I made another mistake over here, placing the arrows. I was not knowing that he was having that ghostly goblin barrels, and he does use a goblin barrel, but I placed the archers. But yes, he made another cheeky move. Flavio making a cheeky move by placing that free spell over to that, and I'm showing an angry face. Come on, you are good luck buddy, because I'm using a very dangerous deck, which is gonna be sure a win deck if you're using properly, and I'm gonna use that properly. So right now placing the golem from the back, and he's trying to come with the giant skeleton from the back. It seems to be like the giant skeleton one of the great units if you are using it very well. I am also having my elixir getting built, and right now it's in a position of good position. Right now I mean also a good golem in the front, and there comes a royal giant. Royal giant is so dangerous with golem combo, as they can do the devastating damage towards the tower, and he's trying to place a minion horde. I place a minion horde to take this pack out, as they can do a great amount of damage to that royal giant. And this time he uses the fireball, and the golem is doing an excessive amount of damage to that tower. And this giant skeleton is going to take this golem easily out by slowly destroying my golem. But he has done a great amount of damage to that tower. Golem is not just a tanking unit. If you are using it properly, it may go towards the tower and can take out the towers very easily. Right now, he's placing the minion horde, but this time my fireball went pretty easily, very, very wide. This time we are in advantage because we have those arrows to take these goblin battles out. But he's trying to push back again with the giant skeleton into the front. But I have those archers to take him, distract him, and as well as the barbarians to take the Pekka out. The barbarians are so dangerous if I not counter with fireball. And he was sucking at that fireball because he was not having fireball, and he made another mistake over there placing the spear goblin. As spear goblin can do much amount of damage other than just distracting my troops. And now I'm placing those arch arrows to take these goblin barrels out. And he's placing the minion out, but as well as the fireball. As you guys can see, the fireballs have done a great amount of damage, and they place a mini Pekka. Mini Pekka is so dangerous that if he has not taken care, it can destroy your damage. But right now I'm placing another giant skeleton, and this archer got distracted towards the mini Pekka, and this mini Pekka is going to go down. So right now my giant skeleton is going to burst into and we are busted, and he's placing another goblin battle. This time freezes, but yes, I have this arrows. It was a cheeky move from my side. And right now, I'm in a great advantage as my golem is moving towards him, and I fireball this area. And there we are, we're going to take this tower out. So hope you liked this episode. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment. If you're a new viewer, subscribe to this channel for more Clash Royale and Clash of Clans. This is Epic Life Clash. There's going to be more quality videos for Clash Royale and Clash of Clans. Thanks for watching this episode.